Good evening. In the 10 minutes allotted to me by the fine folks at YouTube, I will lay out the mystery of the crop circle. I chewed on how to squeeze all the history, the controversies, the theories, the probabilities, and the hype into such a small segment, when it struck me to simply start at the beginning and allow my twisted brain to take me off in whatever direction it wanted. The historical research leads to a short tale in lithograph from the 17th century called The Mowing Devil. The rendering depicts the devil apparently mowing down a field of grain with a large scythe, and at first glance this looks like your typical crop circle. However, many scholars point to the root of the story for the answer. The field represented in the lithograph wasn't just any field. It was a particular field owned by a particularly cheap-ass farmer. A farmer who chose to offer payment to the local mower in a much reduced and unfair amount. This was a serious breach of labor etiquette back in the day, and the mower marched off the property all in a huff. The next day, the farmer found what once was a field of ready-for-Wheaties burned to the ground. Hardly the typical crop circle, to be sure. The locals knew the devil was in the details, and a just reward for unfair compensation had been dispensed by the horned one. In fact, if you look at the lithograph, you will note the fire burning both inside and around the field. It is obvious that there was some well-deserved human justice meted out in that story, despite the ever-so-easily contrived scapegoat. As far as other historical references, there wasn't anything at all substantial until the 1970s, when two local artists, Doug Bauer and Dave Chortley, whilst having a beer in a pub at Winchester, decided to create a circle in a field and watch the reaction of the locals. The UFO craze was up and running about that time, and they felt it would make for good fun to form what could look like a landing spot for some flying saucer. The rest is history. They got their response and made more and more circles until it became the phenomena we know today. Now, the world of crop circles is a divisive one. The irony is that it's as divisionary as it is symbiotic. The majority of those who make the circles and those who research the circles do know how these are being made, but those who benefit financially are bound to the mythology and can't let it go. These are the so-called researchers who derive at least some monetary income from the selling of books, photographs, videos, and attendance at lectures and conventions. On the opposite end of the spectrum are those who make the circles and who gain no financial benefit and construct these living tapestries at risk of criminal prosecution if caught. Researchers will not recognize these artisans for fear of themselves being exposed as being less than truthful profiteers. So a wall of denial is built by researchers, many of whom despise the truth of human construction and those who are involved in it. It is an irony to see disdain for those who actually are responsible for creating the very product that they, the researchers, sell. Nowhere is this division felt more than in the place that started it all and where the majority of circles are still found today, the County Wiltshire in southern England. Wiltshire is a place steeped in mystery and magic, of ancient tales and ancient tribes, of country charm, friendly folk, and, as it turns out, massive amounts of farmland. But it's not so much what you can find in the fields that can shed light on this mystery of crop circles, in my humble opinion. It's what the locals know about it that counts. Anything that can be dreamed, theorized, created, photographed, argued, and fought over has already been done ad nauseum by those who live in and around the Wiltshire area. So having that in mind, what could be better than to visit and listen to what the locals have to say about it? And where could we possibly be lucky enough to find them? Well, my bet would be this place right here, right in the middle of the action. The public house where circle makers can rest and have a tall one whilst drawing out their dastardly plans to cause some serious yet creative damage to some unsuspecting farmer's crop. It's none other than the Barge Inn on Honey Street. Now, you know I'm not one to pass up a pint now and again, so with a beer in hand and through the magic of the internet, let's stop in and hear what one local has to say.
A lot of them haven't done it, and it's, I don't know, like, there's a number of different techniques that people use to do it, and, you know, until I've gone out and tried and experimented with different techniques, I wouldn't be able to say, you know, right, the stalk bends or it snaps or, you know, it's a number of different factors, you know, like if it's dry, if it's young, if it's just rained recently, all of these factors.
Supple, it's not going to break as easily.
Right, yeah, all of these factors could easily affect how the corn breaks, and I think to use that as evidence for whatever, whatever, like aliens are coming down. Right, okay, so what? Aliens have come all the way from however far away, however many million light years, and the only way they can think to communicate with us is by...
Something that we can only see from the sky.
Which coincidentally happened to happen in like a 10-mile radius of the Barge Inn, which is the crop circle center of the universe, you know?
Oh, that's kind of funny about that, huh?
Something doesn't quite sit right with me with that. Yeah, and that's how they generally appear on weekends. All these coincidences, which are like Team Satan, you heard of them?
I've heard of them, yeah.
Right, the one, the bottom right there, that's definitely one of theirs.
Oh, but then,
right. We know, I know the guy who does it, so it's like one of the best makers in England at the moment. Apparently there was two teams out there at the time.
Yeah.
Like, that's why you see such differences. And the circle, the one on the bottom right, isn't finished. You know, like, if you look, it should have been finished round. Well, apparently they freaked each other out whilst they're out there because they kept on stopping. All right, they've gone out. Because there's a popular spot next to the White Horse and everything like that. And so they've gone out and they heard this rustling. What the hell? Everyone drops to the ground. And yeah, they went... They freaked each other out and they both legged it without finishing the formation, you know, but neither one is really finished. And yeah, apparently there was another person who was out looking for the hoaxes that night, and he went in and he found like a tape measure, t-shirts and things like that right in the center of the formation. Oh, that's pretty much all I know.
In visiting the Barge Inn, I can imagine one would feel as if it's a shrine of sorts. A large mural adorns the ceiling and walls with depictions of the fanciful and the topical. The local theme runs throughout, with Stonehenge adorning the back wall and fields of crop circles surrounding it. On one wall, lo and behold, there is a map with locations of the circles made for that season, including photographs of them. One of the more popular circle locations is the field just below the White Horse at Alton Barns, which, as it turns out, is visible from the Barge Inn. The fact is, the Barge is ground zero for the circle makers who come to plan for, recoup from, and celebrate the latest artistic venture into the crops. After the circle is discovered, the place becomes a buzz of researchers, the press, and many an interested local, whom have all come to watch the fun and be part of the grand mystery. The interesting thing is how those on the outside of the situation fail to see the value in these ventures on the part of the artisans, or the why for what they do, and it would be very easy for me just to point to the fields and quip with some because it's their kind of thing, but I won't. The fact is that they do it because of the art, they do it because of the challenge, and they do it for the reward. If you think about it, what could be more rewarding to any artist than to create a massive piece of work in a matter of hours and have such great response in such a short period of time than a crop circle? Professional photographers fly overhead for just that right view. Those who seek inner harmony come to lay inside the circle to feel the energy. Researchers come with their gadgets and notebooks to record their official findings, and once back at the Barge, they discuss, debate, and laugh about this latest monument to the mystery. For those who continue to ask what the meaning is or the message of the crop circles, I submit that perhaps the ultimate message is to the experience. It's a call to come and share in the event and to share with each other something out of the ordinary. After all, isn't that what art is all about? This is Super Soylent. Thank you for watching.